God's Word, faithfully preached, is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives, delivering them from the shackles of sin, the flesh, and the world, and transforming them into useful vessels through whom Jesus can pour out His blessings. Living Seed invites you to a feast of the truth as God's servant brings to us the Word of Life.
Praise the Lord. Go now to Isaiah. Go with me quickly to Isaiah. And Isaiah 49. Isaiah 49. Are you there? From verse 1. Oh, listen. Listen, O eyes, unto me, and hearken, you people from afar. The Lord has called me from the womb, from the bowels of my mother's womb. He has made mention of my name, and He has made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of His hand has He hidden me and made me a polished shaft. In His quiver has He hidden me. Hallelujah. Isaiah 41. These passages I'm reading to you, they are very deliberate because God is beginning to do a new thing in Liberia. And you are central to what God wants to do. There is a divine agenda that God is releasing over the nation. And the future that God has seen is the reason why this student congress has been called. And if God has allowed you to be part of this National Youth and Student Congress, I want you to know that you have a portion in what God is about to do. Amen. Tell somebody, say, my portion will not be taken by someone else. No one will take my place. I'm born to do exploits. Nobody will exploit me. Amen. Isaiah 41. Isaiah 41. Are you there? I'll read verse 14 up to verse 16 for you. Maybe I should read it up to verse 20. Fear not, thou womb Jacob, and you men of Israel, I will help you, says the Lord, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Behold, I will make you a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. Thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and shalt make the hills as chaff. Thou shalt fan them, and the wind shall carry them away, and the wild wind shall scatter them. And thou shalt rejoice in the Lord, and shalt glory in the Holy One of Israel. When the poor and needy seek water, and there is none, and their tongue faileth for thirst, I, the Lord, will hear them. I, the God of Israel, I will not forsake them. I will open rivers in high places, and fountains in the midst of the valley. I will make the wilderness a pool of water, and the dry land springs of water. I will plant in the wilderness the cedar, the shita tree, and the mitu and the oil tree. I will set in the desert the fir tree and the pine and the box tree together. that they may see and know and consider and understand together that the hand of the Lord has done this, and the Holy One of Israel has created it. Praise the Lord. Now, I want us to do one thing before I start the Word of God this morning. I want you to pray personally for yourself now. And I want you to tell God something very personal. You are going to say, God, why was I born? Why was I not aborted? Why was it that during the war, I was not one of those that was shattered, because you were almost a little young child that time. But God kept you because of what? Why did God preserve you? Why are you alive at a time like this? I want you to pray and say, God, reveal to me your purpose for keeping me alive. Let's pray. Let's pray. Call on God. Lord, why didn't I die earlier than this? Why am I here? What is the reason why you have preserved me? Why haven't I perished while all others were getting lost? Lord, reveal to me in the course of these days, why am I alive? What is your divine purpose for my life? What do you want to make of my life? What am I supposed to live for? Naroko shanta bakaura masira. Lento ko sambara bashiri. Rako toko sembara mashanda bakoria. Holy Spirit, be gracious unto me in the course of this meeting. Let your purpose grip my heart. Don't let me roam around in life before I arrive at your purpose for my life. Don't let the devil take advantage of me before I begin to do exploit for you in my generation. Please pray. Don't let the battle over my life render me a cripple before I rise to fulfill my destiny. Holy Spirit, please do this in the course of this meeting for my life. Thank you, Father. Thank you for hearing my prayer. Can you tell God that you will not let him go in this weekend? In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, I have read very, very critical passages this morning, because we are at a threshold of manifestation of divine visitation of God. Whereas many, many people are going to be used of God. Many people may be involved in what God is about to do. Yet the Holy Spirit has particularly turned our attention. And he said, stop mourning for Saul. You remember that God anointed Saul, and after 2 or 3 years, he began to misbehave. And he was on the throne for 40 years. But for 40 years, God kept regretting that it was Saul he brought up. Samuel was crying, what can I do to recover Saul and to redirect him? as he will pray and pray and pray and spend night vigils upon night vigils. But Saul was only progressively going downward. Whatever you did for Saul, Saul was bent on living for himself. Saul was going down. Saul, instead of seeking the face of God, Saul was looking to witchcraft. Whenever he needed to fight a battle, instead of waiting for God, he was dabbling into offices that does not belong to him. Until God stood up and said, I am tired of Saul. I regret raising him up as the king. I am looking for another. How many of you know that God is looking for a young man like yourself here? So God said to Samuel, Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul, seeing I have finished with him? I have rejected him. I am already looking elsewhere. I'm already looking for another man. I'm already looking for someone else that will take the battle to the gates. I'm looking for someone else through which my purpose will be established. I'm looking for someone else, who I will use to do exploits in this coming generation. Now listen carefully. This morning I'm not preaching. I'm just making an announcement to you while you are here in this meeting. Several of you are here in this meeting. You may not know, how did God make it possible for you to be here? It's because there is a divine agenda that concerns you. You say, but I'm a young man. You say, but maybe, but I've made mistakes. That's not the issue this morning. God has preserved you and did not allow you to perish, because there is an agenda over your head. There is a divine focus on your life. When I understood that's what God will have us do, when I recognize that now God is saying, for Liberia, for the rebuilding of that nation, for the transformation of that land, and for that land to fulfill the destiny that was upon this nation when it was established, stop mourning for Saul. And Samuel said, Lord, what do I do? God said, stop mourning for Saul. You will not get far if you spend all your life preparing, panebiting the one that I have already turned my eyes away from. It is not that God will not forgive. It is not that God does not intend to have mercy on any man who cries to him. But God is very strategic about what he wants to do now. And this is important for me to again share with you what is God's agenda and why God is asking us to carry the battle for the young onto a very serious level. Why it must engage all our resources. Why it must consume all our focus. Why God is insisting that where he is turning his eyes, that's where we must throw our weight. And I want you to know that whenever God has spoken like this, and we have obeyed Him, and we have responded to His dealings, it is His own responsibility to make good His promises. And I want to inform you, in a few years' time, you will see the glory of God break forth in this nation. The politics of this nation will turn around. The economy of this nation will turn around. The spirituality of this nation will turn around. But some of you are saying, but we are not politicians. Why don't you gather the politicians? Hey! The Holy Spirit was so clear. The future is not in the present politicians. They are occupying this space, and we thank God for them. But God is preparing a new generation. God is preparing a new vanguard of men and women. But He needs to sit on their lives. That's why we are asking you to come into this divine incubator, so that by the time of your manifestation will be ready, you are going to appear as a sharp arrow in His hand in the name of Jesus Christ. And so God said to Saul, fill your horn with oil. And I want you to know that there is the horn of oil that God is asking us to fill up. To fill up because of you. Because an anointing will come on your life. And that anointing, we will be describing it, but if I just say it's an anointing for exploits, is an anointing for divine transformation. It's an anointing that will be so sharp, as I will be describing the things that the Holy Spirit is wanting me to announce to you. I'm just making an announcement this morning. When I finish this announcement, I will ask you if you are interested. Listen to me. I will ask you if the Spirit of God is moving in your heart to say, you are part of that. Take your place in what God is about to do in your days. And don't waste away your youth. But permit me to finish this announcement before I ask you, should God have caused an interest in your heart about this? Then we will start the meeting from this afternoon. What must I do? What foundation must I lay? And in the course of this meeting, God will be freely speaking into your lives for the purpose of what He wants to do. Praise the Lord. So God said to Samuel, fill your horn with oil. And I must say to you, there is a fresh oil that God is making available. There's a fresh mobilization of God's servants being filled with fresh oil. Not old oil. Not exhausted oil. Not the usual oil. Not the routine oil.
When I hear God saying to Saul, fill your horn with oil, I say, God, which means what Samuel was carrying will not be adequate for the kind of anointing that has to be released upon that new generation that God is talking about. And we have been praying and pleading with God that this new direction that the Holy Spirit is speaking concerning this nation, God will give us capacity to face it, to run with it, until we see what heaven is saying over this nation, until we see it come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. This National Youth and Student Congress is going to be a very major matter for the next few years. I don't know how long it will be, but for the next few years, this will be a very critical focus that the Holy Ghost is saying, fill your horn with oil and go into the house of Jesse. For I have provided for myself a king among his sons. I have sought out a king for myself, one who will do according to what is in my heart. He is among the sons of Jesse. Carry your own of oil, fill it up, and anoint him for me. Divine agenda, divine purpose for Liberia and for your generation. And as I stand here as God's servant this morning, even me, I'm pleading with God that the fresh oil for your own fresh heads and for the fresh assignment ahead of you will not fail to fall in the name of Jesus Christ. Do you remember that Samuel left when he got to Bethlehem, which was a village? Everybody gathered. Permit me to be very frank. I'm just begging God to help you to understand why we're here. Some people may misunderstand, but I don't want you to misunderstand it. Do you know, because Samuel was a popular man of God in the land, Samuel has led the people of Israel to fight battles, and they have succeeded. Samuel had pushed the Philistines backward up to Ebenezer, where they have erected a stone. Samuel, by the grace of God, had been a great prayer warrior. Do you know the reputation of Samuel? They said, there's a man of God here. The word of the Lord is with him. Whatever he says, it comes to pass. That was his reputation. The reputation of Samuel was that the word of the Lord came to Samuel, and whatever he says, God did not allow his word to fall to the ground. So when Samuel entered the village of Bethlehem, everybody gathered. All the old people who used to know him, they came. They said, Samuel, did you come peaceably? We hope there's no problem. We are not expecting a great man of God like you in our village. And if you are coming, you will have told us so that we can prepare to do big things, so that we can organize, so that we can gather all the elders. They did not understand that this coming of Samuel this time is with a different strategy. It's with a different focus. It was a deliberate instruction that the Lord gave Samuel at this time. Oh my God, may God give you understanding. You know, for us, God has given us opportunity of ministry at every level. And if all that we wanted is to say, yes, brothers, we have come again. Let's gather all these people, gather all that, gather all this, gather all this, gather all this. There will have been great movement. And there will have been great excitement. And everybody will have loved to be there. But as we are following divine instructions, and I was very clear to tell our brothers, I said, when I come next, even though I love to meet with all the pastors, we have been doing clergy meetings, and we'll have loved to meet with everybody. The Lord said, no, that's not the focus for now. Go and face the youth. Go and bring me the young men from the universities and the young men on the streets. There is a special assignment that they must carry out in their day. That's why we're here. And I'm telling you, as soon as this meeting concludes on Saturday, we are gone. There's no space for any other. There is no other arrangement. And I'm pleading with God that He will find the men and women, the young people, that He is intending to pour something into their lives in the course of this time, in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody asked, says, sir, is that the only thing you are coming for? Allow us to gather this, gather this. I said, never you try it. Say, give us a week. I said, no. We could have given a week. And it would have been wonderful. But the Holy Spirit is very specific. We are acting on specific instruction now, because of what heaven is talking about. They gathered. Everybody gathered. But Samuel was very deliberate. He excused himself and told the senior men, I just want to do something in the house of Jesse. There's a special sacrifice. They say, when did the house of Jesse become the temple? There's a bigger sanctuary where all of us can gather in the town hall. He said, yes, we used to do that, but for now, it is the house of Jesse that I came. And when he got to the house of Jesse, there was no time to waste. You know what he said? He said, how many of your sons are around? Gather them here. Gather them here. No. There are elders. There are clan heads. There are other people. Are they not involved? He said, no. I'm looking for your sons. That's how this man quickly, began to signal all his sons. Eliab! Abinadab! Shammah! Come. There's a special time for you. all the sons. 7 of them were around. He forgot that he had another one. Even if men forget you, he will not forget you. You know, sometimes people make plans for other things, other people. But for you, they say, well, leave her alone. Leave him alone. It's not very important. This meeting is not for such people. They gathered, and everybody was there. And as Samuel began, as the young men were coming out one by one, this was a very strange meeting. The first one jumped out. I don't know how the man was dressed. I don't know how imposing and impressive he appeared. That even the man of God, who never missed anything before, who has such an accurate anointing to know, even when something is in your stomach, he knows. Imagine how Saul had not yet met him many years ago when God whispered in his ear, by this time tomorrow I'm bringing a man here. And when it was 12 in the afternoon, the Holy Spirit said, at 12, I am bringing that man. You will meet him now. And as soon as the young man came in, are you hearing? These are the reputation of Samuel. As soon as he came in, he said, yes. The axes that your father lost that you are looking for had been found. But to you, it is upon you the desire of the nation. You are the one that your nation is waiting for, to give them direction and to solve their problems. Follow me. That man of God was very accurate. He never makes mistakes before. He never gambles about anything. He knows what to do. But on this particular occasion, when Abinadab appeared, the man of God said, wow, look at him. The anointed of God is before him. And he carried the oil. He carried the vial of oil. And he was about to. Oh my God. God will not make any mistake over your life in the name of Jesus. The anointing that is meant for your head will not fall on the wrong person in the name of Jesus. That's why you are going to be praying this morning. That's why from now till Saturday, you must ensure that you don't miss anything. This is not a meeting you can be roaming about in the town. It is a divine appointment. And you've got to prepare and settle your heart so that what God is about to release over this nation, for which heaven is saying, suspend all other things. Suspend all other programs. This is what I need to do now. And he carried the oil. And suddenly, he was about like this. I tell you, this is about quarter to anointing. The first drop of that oil was about to drop. And you know what happens? If it has dropped, it has dropped. No one else will have to wait again until Abinadab has also finished before God's agenda can continue. But on this particular moment, I saw the jealousy of God. God will be jealous over your head in Jesus' name. I say heaven will stand up to defend your space in the coming move of God. Whatever the devil is doing to replace you shall be scattered here in the name of Jesus Christ. Those of you in the gallery, I hope you are settled. Because heaven, who determined that during this meeting, he will begin to set you apart for the reason why you were born from your mother's womb, it shall fall on your life in Jesus' name. Amen. Suddenly, as Samuel was about to release the oil, there was a shout from heaven. There was a sudden shout from above. Look not! Look not at his appearance. Look not at his countenance. Don't consider the height of his stature. I, the Lord, I have rejected him. I have rejected him. I, the Lord, I looked not on the outward appearance. I look into the heart. And I have looked into the heart of this man. I have rejected him. Wow. That's how the hand of Samuel came down. And he put the vial of oil, put it on the table. I think he must have prayed again. I said, God, I thought he was the one. I thought he's the one we are waiting for. God said, no. That man, I have rejected him. When Samuel recovered with more carefulness, with more prayer, he said, Jesse, any other son? This one has been rejected by the Almighty. Tell somebody, may heaven not reject you in the name of Jesus. If you are in this meeting, whatever must happen to you, for God who brought you here to make you right for exploits in the coming days, we will beg God to do it in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever was in the heart of Abinadab that made heaven quarter to anointing, I wish somebody will bring me a cup of water. And I'll bring young men out here and see what was about to happen before heaven stopped it. He was almost anointed, but rejected. What did I say? Almost anointed, but rejected. What will happen to you will not be almost. It shall be utmost. What did I say? Not almost, but utmost. God will do what he wants to do in your life, utmostly, in the name of Jesus Christ. So when Shammah came out, Samuel was no more in haste. As the young man was coming, Samuel started looking at him, asking a question, oh God, show me the heart of this one. Thank you, sister. Show me the heart of this man. What do you say about this one? Almost qualified, but rejected. What is the thing that makes these men to come near the level of anointing. And heaven will say, put aside. Set aside. Reject. What is it that will make God, when it remains just a little, for you to come into a breakthrough in life, you have a breakdown? They say, he almost made it. Almost made it. Do you remember one man in the Bible that used the word almost? You can't remember him. This man was called Agrippa. Agrippa was a king. Eh? And Saul, Brother Paul was brought before him. And they were discussing. And after Paul finished speaking and preaching, Agrippa said, Paul, you almost made me a Christian. Almost a Christian, but not a Christian. Almost anointed, but not anointed. Almost qualified, but disqualified. Almost in it, but out of it. Almost delivered, but yet in bondage. God has brought you to this point. My cry this moment, it will not be almost for you. You'll not be one of those who tell story and say, I almost got that power. I almost got that anointing. I almost became what they said. I don't know what happened. Everything broke down. No, no, no. God has an utmost for you. That's why I began to ask you to sing that song. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's table and higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on a higher ground. Do you know? They brought Eliab. They brought number 4. They brought number 5. They brought number 6. They brought number 7. God kept saying, mm-mm. Reject. 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 Then Jesse said, I don't know why these my 7 sons have been rejected. I told you God has sent you to this house. You say, yes. God never sent me to do something that is useless. Something must come out of it. So he asked him, are these all your sons? Are these all your sons? He scratches and says, well, there's another one. In fact, it's the last boy. And I never expect. Are you hearing? I never expect that this matter will concern him. So when you say I should bring all my sons, it didn't even occur to me that I should send for him. He's not a significant boy anyway. Actually, he's on the field with the sheep. Can you hear how Samuel said? Go and bring him. Can you imagine God sitting down until you arrive? Can you imagine God saying, every program is suspended until that boy is here? said, the sacrifice had been suspended. We cannot continue the program until he has arrived. All the rejected brothers, they were all on one side. May God never pack you aside among the rejected in the name of Jesus. All of them on that side, rejected. They were asking themselves, what is he looking for that we don't have? Some are wearing tie and coat and suit. But heaven is not interested in that. God is looking for a heart that he can anoint. Aye. While they were all there, rejected. They were using one eye, corner of their eyes, to look at Samuel and say, Samuel, what is all this? So when they went and brought the boy all the way with dirty legs, he had not yet had time to take his bath or to change his clothes. For you to know that God is not interested in how you dress. God's interest is the man inside. Is your heart attractive to God? Is your inner man the kind that God can work with? Hey, as soon as David came in with dirty legs, unwashed hands, uncombed hair, as soon as he was coming, the Holy Ghost witnessed in the heart of Samuel, this is he, this is he, this is he. Arise, 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 arise. Anoint him, anoint him, anoint him, anoint him, anoint him, anoint him. He had not yet changed his clothes when the anointing began to roll on his head. Do you know that anointing is going to roll on your head? In the course of this week, something beyond you will fall on your life. I was going to say, but David did not prepare for that. He did not know. In fact, when they sent for him, come, 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 come. He said, for what? He said, just come, just come. What is happening in the house? They said, just come. Why do I need to come? I have not finished what I'm doing. He said, leave it. He said, but the sheep, I have not yet finished feeding them. He said, leave that. There are bigger sheep you are going to start feeding from here. Oh. Father, let your will come to pass over Liberia. Let there arise from this meeting young men, young ladies, who will bear the anointing for transformation, who will carry the oil for exploit in the name of Jesus. Suddenly, listen, as the oil was poured upon David, in the presence of his brothers, the Bible said from that day forward, the Spirit of God came upon David. From that day forward, when he carried his harp and he begins to sing, you don't know, he will just be singing ordinary song. The Lord is my shepherd,
that shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in the green pastures.
Everybody is wondering, but unknown to people, whenever this boy is singing, there's an anointing that is chasing demons. If he sits somewhere here, I say, oh,
as the deer panted for the water, so my soul longed after you.
Why are you singing? There is commotion in hell. Demons are saying, somebody is singing, and he's causing confusion for us in our kingdom. Where is that man coming from? Sometime he will just take it, it's a tambourine, instrument of 10 strings, and this man will just open his mouth and he will just say,
how am I able to thy tabernacle, O Lord of hosts, how am I able to thy tabernacle, O Lord of hosts.
Even his father, the old man, with everybody in the compound, in the whole of the village, they just knew that something is vibrating. Something that will shake the nation is brewing inside this young man. We don't know why. They said since that day, when he attended that emergency meeting that Prophet Samuel came for, many of us were thinking that Samuel will pray for the rest of us. He just did that and left. He said God did not send him to do normal ceremony that time. Since that time, something strange, something permanent, something eternal, something glorious, settled on the head of David. Are you believing for something to settle on your head before you leave this meeting? I know you have been going for meetings before, but this is a different meeting. This is a meeting that will leave you with a permanent impact in the name of Jesus Christ. Sometime, this young man will go on the field, and as he's taking care of the sheep, are you hearing me? A lion just suddenly appears, wanting to take one of the sheep. Normally, if a lion came to eat one of your goats, what will you do? Abba. You will run away. It's better for the goat to be eaten than for you to be torn apart. Because if the lion did not get the goat, it will get you. And yet, there was an invisible but supernatural strength that is already brewing. Something will brew in you in the name of Jesus. Oh, Robo Sanda Yamama Kondo Robo Shinda Bakawa Masaila. Are you hearing me? This something will be brewing inside of you. People will be wondering, since he went for that meeting, something has changed about him. Something has happened to his life. Something has changed about him. Suddenly, David found something rising inside of him. Say, run after the lion. Deliver the animal. Deliver your sheep from his hand. And so he went. And he grabbed the lion by the neck.
And he tore it with bare hand. He tore a live lion and rescued the sheep. And he slaughtered the lion with bare hand. When he came back home, he said, "Dad, something happened this afternoon." Jesus said, "Yes." He said, "I will have lost one of the sheep. That one that has just delivered. You remember?" He said, "Yes, yes, yes. That one that is white and black." He said, "Yes." A lion came and grabbed that thing by the neck and wanted to start using the claw to tear it like this. Something rose in me. The shepherd rose inside of me. He did not know. People don't know that since that day, the anointing of shepherding that never loses any battle has fallen on David. He said, "I don't know. The thing just rose. And I went after it. And I just heard something say, grab it. And I grabbed it by the neck. And I tore it into pieces. And I rescued the sheep. Thank God. All the sheep are intact. I couldn't carry the lion because it's too heavy. So it's on the field right now. Do we eat lion in our house? Do we eat lion? Baba, do we eat lion?" Baba said, "Eh, you kill a lion. Don't know. We have never eaten lion because nobody could kill lion in our village. You kill lion. Maybe because the Bible used to say, our fathers used to say, that there's a lion called the Lion of Judah. Maybe that Lion of Judah is starting to walk in your life now. We don't know. At another day, another bear, another dangerous animal came. He did the same. He came back home. He said, Baba, it happened again." Jesus said, "Tor, my son, you are more precious to me than those animals. Don't let the sheep that you are keeping, don't let it be the reason why I will lose you." He said, "No, sir. You will not lose me. For greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Greater, oh." No, you see, there's no time to sing. I would have loved you to jump up and sing. But this morning, let's get this quick so that we can pray together. Do you know, as he's moving about, the demons, they just knew that this boy is different. When he sings, demons run away. So one day, his father said, "Now, are you with me? How many of you are following this story right now before I go ahead? Hallelujah! Yeah. One day, Goliath and the giants of Philistine, they gather for a battle. And when Mr. Saul, the king of Israel, the rejected man, when he was going to constitute his commanders, do you know the people he made his commanders? Eliab, rejected. Abinadab, almost anointed but disqualified. Shammah, caught her to break through, but he broke down. Those are the people he put as commanders. Do you not know why the battle is a losing battle for them? When you put the rejected, the one that heaven has said no to, when you put them in front of the battle, you don't know that you have just given the devil a chance to overrun the nation. This afternoon, because of the little space I have left, I'm going to call on you. David just went to the field to go and give food to his brothers. He was going with deep respect to give them food. When he got there, he saw this gagana giant who stood up there abusing everybody. Something inside David said, this is where you were anointed. This one, you will bring him down. So he went and said, excuse me, who is this man? Who is this man? You don't know him? They began to describe Goliath. They said he has 24 toes. He's a 9 cubits tall. They describe all the weight of his weapons and everything. They said, for the past 6 weeks, 42 days, we have been here. This is how he will wake up in the morning. He will abuse us, abuse our fathers, abuse our king, abuse our mothers, abuse our God, everything. Then he said, if any of you can dare me, come out. David said, so where is our king? He said, hey, go inside the cave there. That's where Baba Saul is hiding. Cannot stand. His senior brothers, they saw him, they say, waiting concern you here. Go back home. You are too forward. You're always putting your mouth where it doesn't concern you. Go back home. David said, brother, what is the problem? Is there no cause? This man is abusing God. And you say, I should go back home. How can this one be abusing God? And you are sitting here. You know, as he was saying, you are sitting here. Do you know what they were hearing? Say, you rejected fellows. You that have nothing to do to fight for God. Why are you occupying the place? Can you imagine that people are occupying the place? They are occupying our leadership. They are occupying our government, who has no reason to be there. But why are they there? Listen. Because what God needed to do to you has not yet been done. Some of you, when you go to university, instead of the lecturer to teach you, he will be asking for sex. And it will look as if it's a normal thing. Why are they there? Because you are yet to come. Because you are yet to arrive. When God will release the anointing I'm dealing with now, the anointing for excellence, I can see some of you sitting here, you are going to be vice chancellors of universities. I can see the economy of Liberia being transferred to your hand in the name of Jesus Christ. Why are they occupying this space? Commanders that are toothless. Commander, that the only thing they know how to do is to eat. They cannot even chase a rat. The people are languishing. They don't know what to do again. Because at the altar where they should have been empowered, heaven rejected them. Because of their hearts. Now, this moment, he asks, what did the king say? The king said, if anybody can face him, he will give him his daughter. He said, let's forget about daughter first. Take me to the king. I will face him. That's how some people say, they went. I want you to see the drama. They came. Please come. Come, sir. Please come. This is King Saul. This is King Saul. I want a small young man here. Are you a small enough? Come. Yeah. Come here. Come here, quickly. So, he said, sir, this young boy, he said he can go and face Goliath. Yes, this small boy.
Is it true what they are saying? You.
Don't look at his height, sir. Don't consider whether he's a small boy or not. Something in him, I don't know, but he has something. Tell the king your story. When the lion came to your father's sheep the other time, what did you do?
When the lion came to attack my sheep, I was able to kill the lion.
You killed the lion?
I used my strength. I used my idea to strangulate the lion.
You strangulate the lion? Yes. The other day, when the bear came to your compound, what did you do?
I used the same idea to strangulate the bear.
You just did with it. Where does the strength come?
The one that created me.
The one that is inside of it. You used to be like that, sir.
Whose son are you?
Who is your father? Who is your father in Liberia?
My father in Liberia? My father's name is William. William.
William. Do you know Mr. William? It's one insignificant man. Where's your village?
I keep way at Guinea border, Shangwa.
Almost at the border of Guinea. Shangwa. That's where you come from. Baba, you remember that when you started. When the oil used to flow on your head.
I don't know why it dried.
So all we are waiting for, sir, can you authorize him to go on our behalf?
Can you go?
Yes, I can.
My son, you will go, man.
Yeah.
Deliver us from this ship.
Okay. Are you hearing? So you want to give him your armor?
Yes.
No, he's oversized, sir. And besides, he doesn't believe in the armor of flesh. What you are depending upon now, sir, we don't use such a thing. Do you remember that you did not start wearing armor when God gave you victory? When you left God, you began now to use sugar-coated psychology.
It's not my fault. I had other people.
And then, do you know that the boy that I'm talking about here, if you give him chance, so how do you intend to go?
First, I will seek advice from the one that created me, and I will stand by what he tell me, and I'm going to do all he can.
Whatever he tells you to do?
Yes.
Okay. So do you need the sword of the king?
No, I need not physical sword.
You don't need physical sword. It can go. All right. So that's how the young man, Baba, when he comes back, will tell you, sir. Hallelujah! Is there a David in this hall this morning? Is there a David in this class this morning? Let us continue the story. We stop here. We are going to call on God together. You know the story of Goliath, how everything happened. You know he only carried an ordinary stone. And with a small catapult, it was sufficient. When what I'm praying for happens to you, ordinary things in your hand will become supernatural.
When our cry, God, concerning your life has become a reality, men will be baffled. They say, where is this boy from? Who is his father? He's not one of the notable men in Liberia. But heaven has noted him. It is when God has noted you that you become notable. All those who claim to be notable, who have no secret anointing with God, they will soon be put on the side. Now this moment, the question I'm asking you, are you interested? God said, I will make you a new sharp threshing instrument, haven't it? When we come back and I'll take the next message, I will start dealing with how to be shaped, how to be sharpened for that glorious assignment. But we can pray at this point. And I want you to be very, very deliberate with this prayer, because this is the beginning of it. Eliab was a young man, but he has damaged his life before the day of anointing. Eliab was a young, handsome man. His face is looking nice, but his heart is deformed. He has perforated his life with sin. The day that heaven will have anointed him and made him a great man, his inner man defeated him. Abinadab, the next in line, he could have stepped in and the glory of God would have descended in 5 minutes on his life. Unfortunately, when God looked into his inner heart, he found a deceiver who has been deceiving girls. That particular boy promised to marry a girl. After he tricked the girl and disvirgined the girl, he abandoned her and was now wearing suit everywhere. When the day of anointing came, God said, what of Deborah? What of Debbie? What of Debbie? What of Debbie? Debbie that you have made useless. How can you ride high? You have damaged somebody, you will be damaged. Set him aside. What of Shammah? Shammah, that certificate he carries, it's not his own. It was another man getting caught, and he's getting a job with it. And everyone said, the man we need cannot be a man of dubious character, a man of dubious qualification. Put him aside. That's how all of them, with deformed, perforated, scattered hearts, miss their greatest opportunity to be relevant. But can I tell you the problem? You want me to tell you the problem? When God said, I, the Lord, I do not look at man's appearance but his heart. What do I expect that Eliab should have done? What should he have done? He should have fallen down and said, change my heart. Give me a new heart. Give me a second chance. He did not. Just put his hand in his pocket and went and sat in the seat of the rejected. He was happy to be a commander, even though his life had been rejected. Are you here? You want to be president of your fellowship when your heart has been scattered? Instead of repentance, say, God, if there's another opportunity to anoint somebody, prepare me for it. Why were they like that? They gave themselves over to jealousy. When the Spirit of God began to move in David, instead of them to come to David and say, David, so we miss it. Can you pray for us? No. There's an opportunity this afternoon. Let me inform you. This afternoon is not an afternoon for God to reject you. It's an afternoon for God to recruit you. It's an afternoon for God to forgive you. It's an afternoon for God to have mercy upon those who will say, God, have mercy upon me. You are too young to be discarded. You are just 23. How do you want God to put you on the shelf? You are too young to be put on the shelf. God says, when I see the blood, I will pass over him. That's what is exciting me this morning. That God is saying, yes, gather them. Many of them, they have fallen because nobody has guided them. Some of them, they have run into problems because nobody has taught them. And yet my purpose for them is still there. If only their heart can be changed. If only they can turn to me. If only they can come to me. I am ready to help them. I'm ready to forgive them. I'm ready to cleanse them. I'm ready to give them a new heart so that they can fit into the days ahead of them. Surely, there is a fountain filled with blood, flowing, that whosoever comes to it, he said, I will in no wise cast out. Maybe you aborted when you were 15. And the devil will say, yes. Put her on the shelf. God said, no. You tricked her to do that, but I'm going to give her a second chance. I'm going to forgive her if she can cry to me. I'm going to give her another chance to make it right. I have come to change her foundation so that she can have a chance to live. So this afternoon, just in this moment of prayer, I'm going to give that opportunity. And I want to speak to God on behalf of those who are saying, don't reject me. Don't put me on the shelf. I'm too young to be abandoned. How can I be going up and down in mistakes for another 60 years? I'm too young to just be managing with second-rated life. Give me another chance, oh God. If you are here in this meeting now, and the Spirit of God is confirming to you that the reason why God brought you here, it's because God has not finished with you. It's because even though the devil has been pleading that they should put you on the shelf, God said no. God said, I'm sending my servant to give them another opportunity. As I told you, this is the only reason why we have come this time. There's nobody I can visit. I'm not visiting anybody again. I have so many pastor friends, but we cannot meet with them now. This particular coming is for this purpose. No matter how much it costs, I don't care. Because there's a precious treasure that the devil wants to scatter here. And God is saying, no, go and bring it back. I will make him a new sharp threshing instrument. Haven't it? He is my battle axe. Even though there's rubbish around him, I will clean him up. And I will reset his life. If only he can come to me. We're going to pray. I think you should rise on your feet. Wherever you are. I think you should particularly respond to God for yourself. I think you should call on God. Forget about who is standing by your left, who is standing by your right. It's not about them. It's not important that you see anybody now. The most important person you must encounter is him. You're going to open your mouth to God. You're going to say, God, I've heard you. I'm hearing what you're announcing over my head. I cannot be here and miss my chance. I cannot hear you like this. And I will go back. And they say, did anything happen? Say, well, cut out to anointing. I was put aside. Never will it be for you. Open your mouth. Talk to God the way you want. Present your heart to God. And say, Father, don't allow me to go empty-handed. While you are touching others, while you are helping others, while you are changing other people's lives, while you are forgiving their sins and rearranging their lives, Father, do not pass me by. Do not pass me by. Do not pass me by. Oh God, do not pass me by. Shinda yamakondo roboskuba. Rema saila mashando roboskaila. Rakotos. Mansanta yabakondo roboshenda makorio. Lord, you have sent us here because there's something you want to do. There's a place you want to go. There's a work you want to do. There's a glory you want to demonstrate. There's a power you want to make manifest. And this afternoon, God, Marabashinda, I hear you announcing there are battle axes here. There are future men and women here. Men that will carry an anointing that will be brewing in their hearts, brewing in their stomach. Anointing that will chase out demons. Anointing that will dislodge the kingdom of darkness. Maria Lakatayama Kondorobo. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, walk in this meeting now. From row to row, from place to place, from person to person, from heart to heart. Move in this meeting. Move by your power. Move by your spirit. Do something new in this place. Do something new this hour. Do what no man can do. Go to extent that nobody can go. Indorobo saba baba. Yetori alaka baba 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 baba. Sandorobosh. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, begin to do something now. Whosoever will come to you, say, I will in no wise cast out. Eliab was rejected because he never begged for forgiveness. Abinadab was rejected because he never humbled himself. Shammah was rejected because he was pretending. This afternoon, God, make bare your hand. Jesus, save as many souls as you can do today. Release the power. Release the power. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Why were they rejected? They were hiding their hearts. They were hiding and covering their sin. So whosoever covered their sin shall not prosper. But whosoever confesses and forsakes shall obtain mercy. It doesn't matter how many times you are falling into sin. God is coming this afternoon for a second chance. That if you will only confess, if you will only repent and say, God, give me a new heart. If you have not finished with my life, let the devil not finish me like this. Now it is time. Are you crying to God and say, God, why you are touching others? Why you are changing someone else? Don't pass me by. Do something new in my heart this morning. Don't let my destiny be destroyed today. Give me a new opportunity. Where are you? You want to raise your right hand and say, God, it's me. It's me. I need your touch. I need your help this afternoon. Change my heart. Make me fit for your use. Make me fit for your kingdom use. Don't let me sit in the corner of the rejects. Lord, relocate me this afternoon. Change my story this afternoon. I have done wrong. I have misbehaved. But this afternoon, have mercy on me. Do something that I cannot do for myself. Break the yoke of my life. Break my yoke this afternoon. Meye kerebo samba. Maya rama mama mama. Your right hand above your head. To say to God, today, the 1st of September, the 1st of September, my story must change. My destiny must take a new turn, a new day, in a new month. Do a new thing for me. I have struggled and struggled and struggled. But when you came on David, from that day forward, his life never remained the same. Are you lifting that hand above your head and say, God, I put my hand in your hand. It's me. I need your help. I need your help. I need your touch this afternoon. I need your touch. I need your touch. Change my heart. I'm not going to be in the class of reject. I'm too young to go with that signature. Rejected. Ah, Lord. Majataka robo samba bababa. Yento robo samba rabashinda bakondo robo skyla. Holy Ghost, do your work, do your work. Let the Spirit of God move in this place. Let the Spirit of God break the yoke. Break the yoke. Break the yoke. If you have raised up your hand, in the name of Jesus, listen. Whether you're in the gallery, or you are down here, or you are outside, you've raised your hand. Bring that heart to the Savior right away. Just step out where you are and begin to come to this altar. When you come to the altar, just kneel down and say, God, I have brought it. As deformed as it is, change it for me. I've wasted my life before, but don't let the rest be wasted again. Recover me. Redeem me. Resettle my case. Start afresh with my life this afternoon. Start afresh with my heart this afternoon. I am here. I didn't know that you have a plan. I didn't know what you want to do when I was wasting my life. I was falling into this temptation. I was falling into that sin. I was falling into this one. I don't know what you want to do with my life. This afternoon, oh God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, oh God. Anywhere around the altar, just kneel down there. As much as you can come, just come. Just come and just be on your knees and say, God, if you are not coming, please step out of the way. For those that are coming,
Hallelujah. Karobo shanda ya bakonto robo skore. Rema santa ya bakonto robo shenda makore. Ento korobo samba ruala bashanda bakonto robo skila. Rema siya abash. Meto kozonto robo samba rabashiri. Meko dia lama saba. Yanda kosembo robo shiria. My friend, yes. Yes, just find a place to kneel down. God bless you, my brother. God has noticed you. He has noticed you. Just fall on your face. God has noticed you. Just fall on your face and say, oh God, today I'm too young to be wasted. I will not sit in the class of the rejected. You will have mercy on me. You will change my story. If you are in the gallery and you need to come down, just take a step and come. God knows about it. The Holy Ghost is doing a new thing here. Masaria lama shanda baba. Mosoto robo sanda baba koryo lobo shimba. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Maybe you are not able to come to the altar, but you are on your knees. Are you on your knees? Lift up your two hands. Just lift up your two hands. Say, God, I am here. My future is now in your hand. Change my story. Remove this deformed heart and give me a new heart. Create in me a new heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Now that I'm still young, recover me. Redeem my life. Reset my direction. Replant my feet. Take me away from sinking sand. Plant my feet upon the rock. From this afternoon, oh God, open the fire of oil. Set me apart for your glory. Now I want you to personally now, whatever has wrong, whatever sin you remember, you will begin to drop it in the blood of the Lamb right away. Anything you remember, stolen certificate, you were pregnant and you threw away the baby. God is showing you the face of that baby. Drop it in the blood now and say, God, I did it while I was ignorant. I did it when I was confused. Have mercy on me today. Are you the one that disvirgined a girl by force? Now it is there for God to raise you up. And the devil is standing and say, look at him. Drop that in the blood of the Lamb right now. Just confess it and say, God, I need your mercy. I need you to walk in my life in a new way. I want you to start afresh with me. Lay a new foundation for my life. A solid foundation for the future. Lord, have mercy upon me. Lord, have mercy upon me today. Yeka torobo sambaba. Maria laba taura mashando roboskura. The only sin God will not forgive is the one you did not confess. If you confess, God is faithful, He will forgive.
it will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. But if you hide it, if you decide to pretend about it, you are giving the devil a weapon to pull you down. Open up to God. Open up to God. Open up to God. Korobo Shaba. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Now put your hand on your heart. No matter how terrible it is, God is here to cleanse you and to forgive you. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty,
power
in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood.
Power in the blood.
There is power mighty,
power in the blood. There is power. Power in the blood of Jesus Christ.
There is power
in the blood.
With your hand on your heart. Father, this afternoon, you said, if any man comes to you, you will in no wise cast him out. You said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Terrible things that happen, tears cannot remove them. Even if we decide to go and work hard, he cannot pay our debt. The lives we damage, we cannot bring it back. But this afternoon, we need your help. We plead for your mercy. Look at these young lives that you want to work with, yet the devil wants them to be rejected. This afternoon, Father, because of your loving kindness, we plead the blood of Jesus for cleansing, for forgiveness. Please do it in the name of Jesus. This afternoon, oh God, if you don't change our heart, our heart is so deceitful, desperately wicked. Many times we have promised that we will change, but we cannot, because that heart is too difficult. So this afternoon we are bringing this heart to you. Perforated heart, deformed, deceitful, scattered. You can change it. You said, a new heart will I give you. A new spirit will I put within you. I will take away from you the heart of stone. Do that miracle right away. Change our heart. Replace this heart with a heart that loves you. That from this afternoon, Father, a transformation will take place. The things we used to do, we will not do them again. The struggle we used to have, Father, it will end here. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, when you came into the life of David, he became another man. But say, from that day forward, the Spirit of God came upon David. He saw greater one walking in his life. I'm asking you this afternoon, we have just started this meeting and we see your passion to draw us to yourself, to cleanse us, to forgive us, to give us our own second chances. Now, Lord, let your word prevail. Jesus, come into this heart. come and take your place. Uproot every work of Satan. Every yoke around any of your lives. By the reason of the anointing of the Holy Ghost this afternoon, we break it in the name of Jesus. Addiction to sin. Addiction to secret smoking. Some are on drug already. Some, their school fees, they have squandered, and so they are not in school. This evening, this afternoon, oh God, as I plead for mercy, give us a new heart. Give them a new beginning. They will not continue to be a waste. You are beginning, you are resetting their lives. And I look to you, O God, thou the restorer of things, thou the redeemer. What the devil has scattered, what the canker worms have destroyed, restore it in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. What the enemy had taken away, thinking that he has wrecked the future already, this afternoon, Father, I'm holding your hand. There shall be a restoration. Yeah. There shall be a new beginning. Yeah. There shall be a fresh fire. Yeah. Burning in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Thank you for this moment. As many as are kneeling down, oh God, as they will rise in victory. They will rise not to fall again. Amen. They will rise to walk out of the dungeon of darkness. Amen. Sin will no longer have dominion over your life. Amen. Satan will no longer lord it over your life. Amen. And the past that have been destroyed, God is going to repair it for you. Amen. And from this meeting forward, you will be walking as a new man. Amen. As a new lady. Amen. The devil has thought he will scatter all about your marriage. That you only be jumping from one man to another, from one girl to another. But from this meeting, we bring healing to your lives. Amen. We bring healing to your marriage. Amen. God will settle your life. Amen. There's a future for you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen.